party members an equal chance to vote and to verify that one's vote counted. Our great party, the ANPP, has today shown that in this country there is still a party that does not employ intimidation or blackmail to get its way. Our great party, the ANPP, has today given every compatriot hope that there is still for our country a chance to turn things around, that there is still a chance to come together and move this country forward. Thank you, ANPP, for making us all proud and for giving us this satisfaction. Fellow compatriots and members of the ANPP and my dear fellow citizens, this day could be the day Nigeria has been waiting for. This moment could be the moment Nigeria has been waiting for. My nomination on this day to contest the presidency of our great country symbolizes, in my view, the answer to the dream, aspiration, and prayers of our fellow countrymen and women to have a chance to elect as their president a person they could rely on, confident that he will commit himself not to amassing wealth and the abiding and the bidding of cronies, but to the challenges facing our dear country. Today, our country is looking for a leader who would restore integrity, rule of law, and the confidence of Nigerians in the governance of our dear country, who would fulfill unfulfilled promises in power supply, food production, pay special attention to education, implement and deepen governance reforms to squeeze out corruption and raise high the stakes of committing crime, attract investment and commit a robust, transparent financial services industry and facilitate steady progress everywhere across this blessed country. On this day and from this place, I, Ibrahim SHEKARAU, pledge to fellow Nigerians that I shall focus my attention to all the above if you vote me the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Fellow citizens, this is your day. It is your day because it is for you I stand, and it is your cause I champion. For all my adult life, I have been in public life, working with students, parents, elders, and communities at the grassroots level, and with authorities at varied levels. As a teacher, civil servant, and governor, I have interacted closely with all segments of the public of our society. I have listened, learned, and understood your concerns, how you love this country, how you want to see a Nigeria where there is opportunity for every citizen, how you yearn to see our country make a move that will ensure steady progress. I know how you feel because I am one of you, and because I have listened carefully and contributed to this long conversation. More importantly, I have acted and made difference in the various sectors of our endeavor at the level of my state. For 8 years, I have been governor of Kano State, the most populous state in our dear nation. Kano is one of the foremost states in political awareness, in citizens exercising their freedom of speech and in trading activities. It is a converging place for Nigerians in their varied departments, cultures, beliefs, and languages. As a governor, I embraced all, not symbolically, but through implementing policies that brought people together, that brought minorities into government, and that fostered understanding, peaceful coexistence, societal harmony, and confidence in government. Under my administration, through careful planning and with the support of the people, we made progress in every sector. We broke records in roads infrastructure, water supply, health, job creation and empowerment, investment to improve security, and did more for education than any of our predecessors did over the last two decades. Given a chance to lead this country, I am confident we can build an even bigger coalition for all Nigerians to make progress and realize our collective vision for growing our economy. Fellow compatriots, the PDP government has for 12 years made promises to improve power supply that for 12 years it has failed to deliver, in spite of the billions of naira spent. Nothing came out of the countless promises for improved power supply but frustration. Perhaps the promises were not meant to be fulfilled in the first place. The PDP government has made a promise to fight corruption and entrench transparency. That promise is yet to be delivered. Perhaps the promise was not meant to be fulfilled in the first place. The PDP government has made a promise to entrench rule of law. Yet, lawlessness is what is persistently holding sway in some areas of this country. Perhaps that promise too was not meant to be fulfilled in the first place. How else can you explain it, my fellow citizens? After all, we are all aware that in every other matter, other than what affects ordinary citizens, the PDP government had always done what it really wanted to do, never mind the tactics employed. It has repeatedly, in a number of states, installed itself in power, even where it did not win elections. It has always lavishly provided for and implemented every ceremony it chose to host. Again, only recently, in talking about the 2011 budget, it said officially that it has no absorptive capacity to handle more capital projects. Yet, it provided so abundantly for everything else. So you can see, my fellow citizens, that the PDP government is selective. What it wants to get done, it gets it done. But what it has no intention to execute, it will not implement, notwithstanding repeated promises. My fellow citizens, 12 years of failed promises are already far too long. It is time for the PDP to go. You must give MPP a chance to lead this country in the year 2011. This is indeed our time. And I promise you that, as the All Nigeria People's Party, your party, We shall focus on the challenges facing our country, pursue a truly Nigerian agenda, and emphasize our common destiny. I am very pleased to note that there is already in place a common vision we all are called to pursue. The vision 2020 should be unreservedly pursued with vigor and determination. I believe if diligently pursued, much can be gained from it. Much improvement can be realized in the living standards of poor Nigerians. Foreign investment can be attracted if we strengthen our regulatory environment as envisaged in the 2020 vision. Unfortunately, the PDP government that endorsed the vision has focused its attention elsewhere. It has turned its attention to politics, holding on to power by all means, and a desperate agenda to perpetuate those already in power. As a two-term governor in Kano State, I've seen how ordinary people carry on with their lives, looking not for much, but only enough to make their ends meet. I've seen how people are yearning for good leadership, someone to give direction, to be fair, and treat people with respect. As governor, we brought people together to build more tolerant communities, created jobs, and improved the doing business environment through market reform and provision of better physical infrastructure. My fellow citizens, this is your day, and I ask you to vote for me as President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Voting for me means improvement in power supply, improvement in infrastructure, improvement in education, pursuit of self-reliance in the area of food production, and a robust and transparent financial system. Voting for me also means restoring hope, rule of law, and security, asserting our identity, integrity, and returning dignity to every Nigerian national, anywhere he or she may find himself. Voting for me also means fighting corruption, tossing away double standards, and restoring confidence in government. We all know that the PDP government is a government that uses the EFCC and other law enforcement agencies to chase and intimidate members of the opposition, and yet persistently turns a blind eye on apparent breach of its party members. My fellow citizens, I ask for your support. With your support, I intend to win the presidency of our dear country come April 2011. I ask you to come out and vote for me and to keep vigil to make sure your vote counted. Once in office, ours shall be a participative government. We shall work with you and restore and uphold our cherished values, make relevant all regional lines and that tend to divide us, build a country where religious belief will not be an impediment for anyone, and build a country that treats every Nigerian as equal. A country where every child can dream, aspire, work and realize his or her loftiest dreams. Long live ANPP. Long live Nigeria. Thank you and God bless. ANPP. ANPP. AMPP.
The AMPP's presidential flag bearer flew to Kano, where he arrived to a rousing welcome. Outside the Malama Minikano International Airport, party supporters and admirers lined up along major streets of Kano metropolis to welcome and congratulate the Sradona. His first port of call was the MS Palace to seek the blessings of the Royal Father.
Kampala.
Malam Ibrahim Shekarau later addressed the people of Kano State, where he thanked them for their support and cooperation. He also called on them to come out en masse and participate in the voter registration so as to elect leaders of their choice. Days continue to unfold, people's anxiety is also growing. Anxiety for a positive change that will bring about peace, security, and prosperity in Nigeria. April 2011 is around the corner.